officially back to Enderal. Day in the Heretic has been languishing just a bit, because with the recent release of Skyrim, it's been eating a lot of my free time, shall we say. And so, we're here in the marketplace in Ark, and honestly, I'm not sure what we're supposed to be doing right now because I, like an idiot, didn't actually check my quest log. Okay, I remember that we talked to a merchant who told us about assassins. Supposed to meet just far at the marketplace when I'm ready for having my fever examined by his employers. There's a troll causing trouble outside the gates. And Tara Hootie back in her wood is probably going to be missing her file for quite some time.
Look who's arrived. Did you have any problems finding your way around? This city can be quite a maze if you don't know it.
Well, no. I was hoping I could spend some more time in here. Walk back on the road from the
aged man's abode. Ugh, blazes. Sorry. I know. I can't sing.
Well, I'm supposed to be following you around, aren't I? Bread fresh from the oven. Are you just gonna sit there? Treat yourself. I guess. Okay. Mm-hmm. Who are you?
Wait. I think I know you. You work for the Order, don't you? Why are those wild mages up in the temple? Malthus, forgive my doubts, but why would the Grandmaster side with heretics? It just doesn't add up.
You know, it doesn't add up for me either. Aura Stonehand, how's business?
Oh, how nice of you to ask. I can't complain. I suppose the wars in Kilay and Kira make it harder to get your hands on certain wares. But still, life's good. Definitely more comfortable than my time on the road, though.
Oh, you were on the road? Were you a caravan person, or were you homeless?
What? No, I was a vagabond, as people like to say. A traveling mage.
Ah. So how do you become a vagabond?
You know, I grew up in a village near Duneville. Actually, I had a pretty good childhood there. But when I discovered my magical gifts, well, let's just put it this way. It changed how people treated me, even my own parents.
Well, that sucks.
I just felt the need to, I don't know, get out, see some of this world. So after I did the passage to the water, that is, after the Order taught me how to use my magic path, I decided not to return to my village and packed my traps and hit the road. Kind of bold, yes, but back then, I didn't care. But I digress.
So I'm kind of a mage myself. You did the passage of water? What is that? How does that work?
Hard. The Arcanist made it clear that we stood at the crossroads. Either we learn to control the magic, or we become outlaws. It was not a pleasant time, I can tell you that much. The keepers were extremely strict, and you learned to be independent, to not get too close to anybody. But no offense, that's a very personal topic.
I'm sorry. And what happens to people who don't make it through?
As I said, I don't want to talk about it. Sorry.
Okay, I won't push you anymore. Weren't you afraid of bandits?
Well, that's one of the upsides of being an Arcanist. You don't need to be a bulk of muscle to defend yourself against a pack of wolves. Plus, back in those days, the roads were safer by far. All these brigands, the frenzied fatirs, the lost ones, that's new, for whatever reason.
You've got something wrong with your mouth. Do you mind if I ask you about how people treated you differently back in the village?
Well, they weren't exactly hostile to me, but it was the small things. Looks, talk going on behind my back. Over time, that just gets to you. But you know, I don't think I can blame them, especially with the village folk. The word magic is always mentioned together with wild magic, or Baeus and devastated cities. And all of a sudden, here I am, suddenly one of them who can do those things, even though I don't have Eterna blood. How is that supposed to fit into their worldview? They can't really know better.
I suppose so. sounds tough.
I probably made it sound worse than it was. I've heard that on Nirum, magically gifted people get driven out of their village, or worse. I guess I should consider myself lucky.
True. Well, what do you have in stock?
Sure, take a look.
169, that's a lot more than I want to be paying. That's half my money right now. You have
Walk
a great day.
Blessed. Hungry for arcane secrets?
I suppose I should tell you guys.
Books, scrolls, potions,
while I was off camera, I went back to the word escapes me, starts with an M.
Work.
Basically, I took the skill that lets you move faster with the bow. So, you know, that'll be useful when I'm pelting people with arrows. I have 666 arrows, that's cool. So for now, we're looking around. I'd like to see if I can't scrounge up three more apprentice books of archery to get that up to 25. Or 26 with the boost of skills. I've also bought 10 books of alchemy, so hopefully we can make some potions when I get the chance. But for now, do you have any apprentice archery books? I need food too, I guess.
Sure.
That's the half piece, okay. Not too expensive either. That's a sweet roll, that is not a date cake. Very well, I will take some sweet rolls. I don't care what you say, those are sweet rolls.
Have a good day.
Any other merchants I can buy from? General store, I guess? A meat market. What, my good sir, what can you get for me?
Malthus's blessing, dear sir. Might I interest you in a ware from my most exquisite assortment?
Sure, show me what you got.
I am certain you will find something.
Read both of those. Roasted poultry meat. Let's see, that's 100 gold worth of salt. Do I really need that? No, I don't. How much food do I have? I got a good deal, I think. Might use some salt if I have any.
May his light guide you. Come back if you find the time.
I will find the time.
Hear my words, path-abiding people of this holy city. Many of you may have heard it.
Bang, right.
There's war in War on Nirum. War on Kile. Red madness. The fuck is wrong with this world?
Well, you see, there are people in it. And we have a tendency to have that effect on the world.
Walk blessed. What can I do for you?
any tips for an adventure?
You're asking me? I'm flattered. But let me think. You know, my grandfather always used to read to us from this old book, Myths and Legends. I think one of the former Archmagisters of the Order wrote it, and there were all kinds of tales about those mythical creatures that apparently roam Enderal. Grandpa always said they were just tales, but who knows? You should go to the library. Maybe they still have a volume of that book there.
Okay. What do you have for sale?
Sure.
No apprentice books.
May your path always be
I've
even.
I've asked you.
Apples, dates, bananas.
Who are you? What do you have? You have fish?
Right. Renard Shalom, my sir. Are you looking for fresh fish?
You're not Andralian, are you?
Kirash, what gave me away? My skin or my accent?
Well,
yes, I'll have to work on my disguise then. Jokes aside, I am from Kaira, but I was only 6 years old when my commune came to this country, and I'll have seen my 60th winter next month, so I suppose that makes me as Enderalian as most people around here.
I suppose. So why'd you leave Kaira?
Oh, there were many reasons. Suffice it to say that Kyra isn't the glittering, exotic country of dreams and poems that bards make it out to be. I am glad to live here. You can say what you will about Enderal, but at least it's peaceful.
You kidding me? I've been attacked by bandits so many times on the roads I can't even count them. Yeah, show me what you got. Fish. Looks like fish. Okay.
May your path always be even.
Misha Gobbledygook.
Have you heard the news about the Magister? Word has it that he murdered 30 novices, then killed himself up in the temple. Oh, by madness, what has become of this world?
I'm sure I don't know. Alright, what's over here? What's this arrow pointing me to? The foreign quarter. Oh, a blacksmith. What do you have?
War on Nerum. War on Kile. Red madness. The fuck is wrong with this world?
Can I use this boat for anything? I can smelt ore into metal ingots. But I don't have any. Oh, you can turn Dorban ingots into scrap. Or, sorry, the scrap metal of an ancient nation into Dorban ingots.
Hungry for arcane secrets? I have books, scrolls, potions, anything for friends who have like magic.
Excuse me, do you have any bows?
Oh, hello. I haven't seen you around here before. Just take a look around and tell me if you see anything you like.
I will do that. Where do you get your wares from?
That depends. Some I get from adventurers, some from other merchants, and some I gather myself in old ruins and the like. Or should I say, gather. Nowadays, you can't even set foot into a deserted house without getting eaten by lost ones. What sad times we are living in.
Well, hopefully you have something I need. What do you got?
Oh, a bit of this and that. Feel free to take a look.
Archery books. Apprentice books of archery. Yes, thank you very much. I have just enough for one more. Do you have any blueprints for bows? It would seem not. I will be coming back to that once I reach it. What was that way at the bottom?
Oh, a bit of this and that. Feel free to take a look.
Ah, scrolls of teleport. That's useful. I will take at least one of those because, you know, it'll be good to have. Don't have enough money for that now. Can I sell you anything? Yes, I can. I'll sell you two of those. That one. This, that. Is there somewhere I can disenchant these, maybe? We'll keep that around. It looks like the potions I make don't increase the health
blood
problems, which will be good to know. Are you an archer?
Greetings.
Show me what you're selling.
Aye, sure. Take your time. It's not as if there's much to do down here anyway.
Yes! Archery books! And I can. Yes, I can. How many of those do I need really quick?
What?
Didn't mean to do that. Oh well. 24.
Your travels.
Give me one more, sir. No? Sorry.
Aye, sure. Take your time. It's not as if there's much to do down here anyway.
Anything else I can afford from you? Those are all expensive. My sneak ad right now. I wish I could afford more of those, but those are really expensive books.
It's like you walk blessed.
Tyrell, sure. We'll buy two of them. Two of those sneak books, please. Because that's about all I can afford right now. I feel really silly because I probably should have saved at least some of my money for Ambrosia, that's what it's called. Oh boy, those would be nice too. But hey, apprentice book, sneak. Did I buy too many of those? I have that. And one apprentice book, archery. Archery to 25.
Well,
how many learning points do I have left? Oh, a good number.
Greetings.
Alright. So we've got our archery up to acceptable level. We've got our sneak slightly better. Let's go get me some treatment.
This holy city. A miracle has happened. A miracle that must have been.
Well, look who's arrived. Did you have any problems finding your way around? This city can be quite a maze if you don't know it.
No, just fine.
Right.
Yeah, apparently I'm used to
these. They're quite fascinating, these places, aren't they? You can climb high, and you can fall just as deep. And every place vibrates with life.
That's true.
Here, put this on. And before you ask, yes, it's necessary. Just trust me.
What am I wearing?
His fearless leadership shall be what helps us find our way.
I look like I could be riding a sleigh and you know, helping a fat man sing ho ho ho. Who was this? I look like an elf.
That's it. And why is it Malphas who carries the Sun Temple on his back? Isn't that a gesture of servitude?
No, Malphas carries the Sun Temple because he also carries humanity. Without the benevolence and sublimity of the gods, the world would still be at war, just as it was after the devastation of Starfall. Everything we have, we owe it to them.
That's not indoctrination at all.
The gods' reign is not...
Oh, you're bringing me to the noble quarter. Didn't you say that only the nobles are allowed here? Do the nobles really have that poor taste in clothing? Okay, don't say anything because
greetings.
If you speak, they'll know. You are speedy, do you know that?
So, about this fever. Usually those gifted with magic have to report their talent to the Order, and then pass a ritual that teaches them how to deal with their magic. The journey to the water is what they call it. Once they've passed that, the fever reduces to an endurable level, and new Arcanists have their names registered in some kind of holy book. But there are other ways to get rid of the fever, and I hope my employer can tell you about it.
Then? Sorry, don't mean to lag behind.
Okay, almost there.
Okay, what is that? What is... Oh, that's to the outside, okay.
Pathlessness, wherever you look, where is this supposed to lead?
Mm-hmm.
Just far, go ahead. This aspirant is getting in your way, isn't he?
Well, bless it, my sir.
You too, my sir.
Fades away at the end of the day.
Finish, Jasper. It's a nice view. Ooh. That's a nice and fancy statue, isn't it?
Hold it, my sir. No civilians beyond this point without explicit permission. Who are you, and what leads you to this holy place?
Business. I'm Jaspar Dalveric, and I work for the Naramese mages.
Oh, right. The mercenary. And who's your companion?
Marijo de Luna from Ostian. Esteemed holder of de Luna's Empire of Tender Fragrance, the most prestigious perfumery in all of Vind. Archmagister Marigil sent for him. Didn't he tell you?
The Archmagister. Well, that does sound like him. Fair enough, you may pass. But show this place the respect it deserves, Miss Mary.
Yeah, that's definitely me.
You have my word, lady. Thank you.
I make potions. Perfumes. Yes, that's me. You won't mind if I take this room? Nope, nothing happened. Let's go, mercenary. I'm gonna enjoy calling you that. Big doors. Oh, that's appropriate, having a tool to about taking an area that doesn't belong to me in a busy area. That's thievery, apparently. Even if it's not marked as directly being stolen.
Ah, there you are. Magister Carlos is the
nice trick. Well, that went better than expected.
What's that?
I don't know.
Marijo de Luna's Empire of Tender Fragrance?
Hey, it worked, didn't it? That's all that matters. Nobody will suspect someone who's already in the temple. Anyway, I think it's about time I tell you a little bit more about this employer of mine. His name is Constantine Firespark, and he's one of Narath Zorrenthiel's former followers, which the new Grand Master, Teolor Orenthiel, brought here by ship about 2 years ago. That means he's one of the former arch-enemies of the Order. They usually wear green, while the Order wears white or red. That should make it easy for you to tell them apart. Firespark's pretty much the eldest of Narathzul's mages, and quite well-versed in magic, at least from what I've heard. Plus, he's a very gentle and likable fellow, which is why even the keepers like having him around. Let's hope he can tell us a thing or two about these visions, and help you get rid of the fever. Come, follow me.
Alright.
Walk blessed, sister.
Let's go and get that fever cure, please.
Ah, there you are. Magister Carus has been looking for you.
Carus? What's that?
I don't know, but I think it's about the tome he wanted you to transcribe.
You know, moonwalking on stairs is an impressive trick.
By the way, have you seen this new Naramese mage woman? Pegasus, or whatever?
Will you follow me through? Yes, yes, you do. Wonderful.
There you are. Walk blessed. Do you have a moment?
Me?
Ah, greetings. Of course. Oh, okay. What do you need?
The Archmagister ordered me to find out more about
that just might work.
The one that took place shortly before the cleansing. That's your area of expertise, isn't it?
Well, I did study the chronicles, so I suppose
that's
so.
That's what they are. All
what
of them.
Do you
I'm
need
dropping.
Know?
I'm just studying this wall.
This jackal, the commander of Dilgar, who incited the conflict. What do you know about
this? Doesn't make any sense.
Only what's written in the old
be easy.
This is holy ground, Outlander. You don't belong here.
I will have you know that I am the best perfumist this side of the side of the inn.
All right, here we are.
Ooh, enchanted table.
Hang on.
No. That's not how you do it.
Blast it! I'm just being careful.
I just can't bloody believe it. Thing. Now.
Ah, they're alchemists, I see.
Blasted, blistering blazes! That's what you get for working with
blazes. I just can't bloody
I
believe
told
it.
You, we Most should be spot. Careful. What? Now, who the heck are you? Can't an old man have a moment to himself?
You hired me, the Magister, don't you remember?
Oh, right. Joseph the Scrounger. So, why are you here? Had any luck?
Just spar. And yeah, we did find something. I
suggest you first of all tell me when I allowed you to drag your drinking mates up here. Do you need me to explain the meaning of the words highly and confidential to you?
I'm sure there's a lot you can explain to me, but let's save that for later. This particular fellow over here needs your help, to be frank.
Steel
arcane
killed
fever.
By the spoon.
Is that so? And what exactly has that got to do with me? Let the keepers and their holy rituals take care of it. What is it with the costume, anyway?
This man's magic is different, Meister. Just feel his aura and you'll see it.
Apparently it's
Plus
purple.
Plus it's from Nerim, just as you are.
Well, all right then, for nostalgia's sake. I really hope you're not wasting my time, though. Working with these religious buffoons is bound to make any rational-thinking person go bonkers. Anyway, that chair over there. Take a seat, and I'll have a look at that fever of yours.
This one? Oh, gosh, I still have enough.
This will tickle a little.
Tickling bad.
Yeah, you're right. This aura does feel different, complex somehow, and powerful.
I appreciate
and
it.
And do you really want to
stop.
Tell me you've only recently discovered that talent of yours? With that aura, I'm surprised that you haven't turned into an Obaya by now. Fine. We will help you. But first, tell me everything. How you got that magic, and how you met that scrounger.
Let's see, I got dropped off a... I got... My friend got stabbed, I got dropped off a ship.
I see.
And then I got blown up by bandits.
Regarding this vision thing, I think that your mind simply played a trick on you there. Not that it's much of a surprise, considering what you've been through. Actually, you were quite lucky that the sudden outburst of your glance didn't blow your head right off.
The sudden outburst of my glance? What's a glance, first of all?
By all that's holy, I won't start playing your tutor now.
Please.
If you don't know about the basic functioning of magic, then read something from Balador Goldenstein.
The glance on the sea of eventualities. Alongside, but apart from the reality we're in right now, exist countless other realities, in which some events have different outcomes, so to speak. A version of this very same room, for example, with the very same people in it, only that Meister Firespark's beard is on fire. And what defines an Arcanist, someone capable of magic, is that he or she can see those other realities and let parts of them come true.
Well, look at that, Jasper. You surprise me.
That's what I'm being paid for.
How powerful an Arcanist is depends on three factors. How far away are the eventualities that he can see? How well he can bring parts of them into our reality? And finally, how well his mind can handle seeing other realities simultaneously with ours? Lighting a candle is easier than calling a meteor from the sky, to speak plain in Al. But, as I said, read Goldenstein if you're interested in the topic. I'm not going to waste any time with lectures.
Do you have a copy of the book? And, yeah, this chapel on the water. Every time I touch one of those stones, I feel as if, I don't know, as if something comes back to me. That'll be the memory points, then.
Well, that's probably a sign that you should go easier on the booze. Skill, whether of physical or magical nature, isn't gained through touching some stones, but through hard work and discipline.
And apparently
even
through
though
reading
this
books.
Screwball Enderalean talk of paths and predeterminations tries to tell us otherwise.
So yeah, I just imagined those visions. They felt real.
Oh, well, if that's what you want to believe, go for it. I, in any case, never come across such a phenomenon in over 50 years of studying magic. And now we should...
It all begins with the dreams.
What the blasted, blistering blazes? Does this room look like the bosom of a whore to you? Or what makes you think you can go around touching anything you get your fingers on? These documents are confidential, for heck's sake. I knew it was a mistake to hire a thug like you. Lashery always had a weakness for...
Correct me if I'm wrong, yes. But I remember you telling me something about dreams that led you and Tealor Renthiel here, didn't you, Meiser? And you told me that in this vision of yours, the Veiled Woman said this. It all begins with the dreams.
What? Is that true?
Yeah, actually.
Oh. Then this near-death experience you had before you woke up on the shore, tell me again, what exactly? Did you see in it a room?
A glistening white light, charred bodies, but you know, they weren't. It's not like they were fully burned, it's like they were dead and then burned. Their skin was gray. I heard all these voices.
Well, this is strange indeed. Anyway, for now, all that matters is that we get that magic of yours under control.
W of Ambrosia.
Whatever you clairvoyanced back there is of no use to us if you're dead as a doornail in a couple of months.
I appreciate the sentiment. And how do we do that? I mean, get my magic under control, I mean.
Well, that's usually a plodding process. The fever you feel is a result of your mind not being able to handle all of these possibilities, so to speak. The ritual the Enderaleans practice to get the glance under control is called the Journey to the Water. Put frankly, it means 1 year of hour-long meditation, bland food, and abstinence from anything that makes life worth living. In due time, the Arcanist then learns to filter these other realities from ours, and the fever gets less and less. Anyhow, luckily enough, we Neremese know of a way to quicken that process.
Good.
A shortcut, if you will. I'm not capable of performing it, but another one of us is. Her name is Lashery, and you should seek her out as soon as possible.
Wasn't she the one you were yelling at? Yeah, I mean, I'm all for shortcuts, because I just don't have a year to sit around and do nothing. I'd like to get started adventuring and, you know, earning money and having more than 22 cents to my name. Oh yeah, what's the shortcut involved? Isn't there a reason for having such a lengthy process?
There is indeed, and this reason is called ignorance. The Order's rituals haven't changed since the Lightborn slipped out of their cradles, and the Keepers do their best to keep anything progressive out of their country. But please, if you're up for a year of austerity and stern-faced magisters scolding you, go for it. I really don't care.
Fair enough. All right, let's do this. Where can I find this Lashery?
She's currently in a ruin called Old Rationgrad, not far from Ark. Just tell her that I sent you. Give me that map of yours. Okay, now you'd have to be a total idiot to miss it. I recommend leaving for the ruin straight away, And you, Joseph, you're going to come with me and show me what your trip to the Sun Coast brought forth. Hopefully, more than a bottle of honey wine and a hangover.
Quite a character, isn't he? But I like him somehow. Here, I owe you this for your help back in Riverville. And in case you're in the mood for a mug of ale and a good chat, just drop by the Dancing Nomad in the Stranger's Quarter. I'll get myself a room there for the time being. With all that said, good luck mastering your magic, my friend. I'll see you around.
Ooh, 600 experience? What else? Oh. During the main story of Enderal, you have the opportunity to deepen your bond to several persons. These missions aren't available forever. If the main story progresses too far, the storylines of some persons stay hidden. What you're saying is, sometime I... Excuse me? 100 coins? Do you know how long I was running around there?
No, the that Magister ordered me...
100 coins, that's one book!
...to be here, to be honest. Funerals...
Never walked back home...
First... We're going to disenchant some crap.
Ugh, blazes. Sorry. I know. I can't sing.
Sure. Yes. And we're going to keep that because it's useful.
Hope he knows what he's doing.
What do you mean?
Oh! Alchemy table. So, the question is, will they notice if I steal this? And will they care?
Pathlessness, wherever you look, where is this supposed to lead?
So what we're going to do is we're going to very quickly nab some of this stuff, taste it. But that's not what I wanted to grab. Apparently you can't grab that, okay. And let's very quickly try to craft that. Weakness to fire, damage mana. What can we make? Well, let's make some restored health potions. With our freshly better, you know, with our much better alchemy skill now. Well, that's our crafting done. Oh, yes, there's an idea. There's also nobody here for us to watch to see it, to see us steal this, so we're gonna take that and go smelt it. I don't know what I was expecting there. Yes, Siri Bob, nothing happened there.
Let's hope he knows what he's doing.
That's not filled. Okay. So what we're gonna do is we're going to take this and this, and we're very quickly going to.
Well, I did study the chronicles, so I suppose.
I didn't mean to do that. Did any of you notice that?
This jackal.
None of you noticed that, okay.
Who incited the conflict? What do you know about him?
Only what's written in the old lore. He was a fast climber.
Don't mind me.
He wasn't born into the caste like most Sun Priests are.
Pathlessness, wherever you look, where is this supposed to lead?
Yes.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna disenchant that sword and put it on our bow instead. Yes, that's good.
Start a war that divides the entire Pyrian realm? That sounds more like fanaticism to me.
Something an idealist would do. Constantine.
Yes, probably.
I got a quest walking in here. Something for Magister Rhaegon.
But maybe yes, something happened.
What is troubling this Magister?
My thoughts exactly. Any idea what?
No, nothing, but I'm not certain I understand why this is so important to you. The Grand Master wants us to examine the Pyrian history for hints about the cleansing, not for the motivations of some crazed commander.
Well, I thought that maybe there's a connection between the two. But anyway, thanks for helping me out. I will see you at the night sermon.
Yes, walk blessed.
Walk blessed.
Can I call you Ronald? Is there some kind of problem?
Oh, yes. Guess what? There is. Some people just don't get the meaning of the word reliability.
So, who's not being reliable? Can I help?
Huh. You're not from the Order, are you? Then I wonder what the blazes you're doing here. But, fine. Who am I to reject a helping hand? Elia, the novice who was assigned to me. She's supposed to help me transcribe these Pyrian tomes the Grand Master is so obsessed about. But 2 days ago, she simply vanished. If I were to guess, I'd say she's strolling around enjoying herself somewhere in the Nobles' Quarter. I'd go look myself, but I'm lucky if I get to breathe within all this work. Go find her, and tell her to get her bloody ass up here and help me. If you do that, it won't be to your disadvantage.
I suppose there's no reason not to. Who are you? Arcanist? Are you an Arcanist too?
What? What? What?
Pathlessness, wherever you look. Where is this supposed to lead?
Don't you dare crash on me. Oh, yeah, there we go. And hey, a chest. I remember this. This is our secure chest. This is where we can store all our crap. Oh hey, I can enchant that too. And while we're doing that, let's see how much of this we can actually disenchant. Okay, let's go make some potions. And enchant our sword.
This is holy ground, Outlander. You don't belong here.
I apologize. I'll be right out. Thank you for your time.
Let's hope he knows what he's doing.
All right, is there a library somewhere I can go to? This is going to be a common theme of waiting for this, aren't we? I'd like to know why, because it's... It doesn't take long once you
this
get the
is holy
crap.
No.
Alright, all the... My curiosity right now. What is it like up here? We're standing on top of Great Malthus's back. Overlooking the entire city. So, where are we heading to? This temple place. That's not what I'm looking for. Well, that's not too far. That's actually pretty close to the Myriad Tower. So what we're going to do is we're going to get out of here first of all, because I don't want to get arrested for being where I shouldn't be. Then we're going to go to the Myriad Tower. We're going to ride a giant bat to a tower in the Heartlands. That's if we have enough money to do so. I get the feeling like asking, do we have enough money for it, is going to become a theme.